Why is there police everywhere today? Okay, it seems like there was some interesting hardware stuff today. Stuff with, I guess, drone delivery and cameras. Like, how about this for the first one? Apparently, this is breaking the internet again. And I say again because this is old, but I guess for some people it's new. So how about I throw it here? Let's see if it'll make people all riled up. It's basically a meme where it shows you like a picture here with all these animals and I guess like a person with a shotgun. And it says here, pick two. They will defend you. The rest is coming to kill you. So I guess it's a debate of survival. So what would you choose in this situation? You get to choose two. For example, I guess like 50 eagles, 3 bears, a person with a shotgun, 10,000 rats. Like, which one would you choose? Basically two of them if you had to survive for your life. Again, it seems like everyone's like arguing with each other. For example, some people would say 10,000 rats, I can't defend you for anything. But again, it's 10,000. Imagine them all swarming you in some way and they're saying like, oh, it has disease and all that. Whereas other things I've read, for example, some people would say, oh, the guy with the shotgun, what, one bullet and that animal's dead or whatever. But then people were saying things like, yeah, right, have like 50 eagles at you, like good luck with that. So which one would you actually choose? Actually, one thing I don't even know if it's true, if there's anyone that actually uses a shotgun, they were saying the guy in the picture with the way he's holding it, people were saying there's no way you should trust that guy to use a gun. Is that true? And today was a big day, I guess, for camera release. Sony released their A7S III. Their old one, the A7S II, has been like, what, 5 years apparently? So this one was basically highly anticipated, especially with Canon releasing their EOS R5 that shoots 8K. Did this one shoot 8K and stuff? Actually, it does not. But instead, from what I gather, they're trying to make a really awesome, I guess, 4K camera overall. So it shoots at about 120 frames per second if you want, 10 bits, ISO 40, to 409,600. That's basically for like the low light. That's kind of crazy. You look at their samples, for example, in terms of going up in a really dark area, that is nuts to be able to get that kind of picture quality with a camera. This is more video oriented, so it is actually more meant for people who want to shoot things like film or basically even like home videos, I guess. But at the same time, it does take pictures, but this is one of the things too, because I always say numbers of megapixels and stuff don't actually mean anything in general if you don't get down to the nitty gritty, because this one here is apparently only 12.1 megapixels. So when you hear that, it's like, what? That's so less than the competition, that's horrible. But the pixels in this one are actually bigger. That's how they're able to achieve things like the good low light performance. It's kind of funny, like when you read their specs on their site, they even say here, number of pixels, bracket, effective. So yeah, just because you have like a million pixels or whatever doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be good if they're not actually like good quality in many ways. It does have in-body stabilization as well, so that's always great because you can't always have like a huge gimbal with your camera when you're carrying it around, especially if you want to just grab something and start shooting. They did revamp the menus too, which is always one thing that's horrible when it comes to Sony cameras in general. I think even like with this action camera, man, try using the menus compared to something else. It just seems so, I don't know, prehistoric with the way it's designed. Again, it's great to see competition. So what is the price of this thing? I was reading how apparently this was going to cost like almost, what, 4,000 pounds or something? Like in the UK, like 4,000 pounds in the UK, wow, that's expensive. But looking at like this site, it says it's going to be about $3,498 US. So it's still within the high tier range, I guess you could say. But with that thought again about competition, the Canon EOS R5 is actually $3,899. So I'm guessing they kind of wanted to undercut them a bit to make it a little more appealing, I would assume anyways. So it's kind of an interesting debate there. If you're looking for a camera, would you go for like things like 8K, for example, or would you stick to the 4K that would last longer? Because apparently this one does a better job in terms of shooting continuously, like not overheating necessarily so fast, and then that's it. You have to wait for it to cool down. Just from my observation from seeing the videos too, it seems like the stabilization, like the in-body one in the Canon, seems a little better just from what I've seen again from the videos that were published. But yeah, I guess it gives a lot of people different choices. I suppose if you want to shoot things like low light and nighttime, then this one would be the way to go in terms of a video camera. But I guess for drones, it's kind of interesting reading this. It says EV maker Workhorse is pairing vans with drones to drive deliveries. Electric truck maker Workhorse has another product up its sleeve that the company hopes will make trucks that deliver packages to business and households even more efficient. Autonomous drones. So I was looking at some of their videos, and you can see, I guess they partner with things like UPS too, and it says UPS Workhorse tests unmanned systems for coronavirus response. So you can see, I guess the drones taking off from the trucks and all that. And again, it seems like that coronavirus stuff is basically encouraging companies to accelerate stuff like this, which I think is good overall. Look how big that cheek is, that squirrel. It's like it got stung by a bee or something. All right, see you guys later.